Beautiful, smart, smart, and kind. Kind, smart, and beautiful.
You're
Just throw
kind,
all of them
smart,
in.
and beautiful.
Are you really trying to flatter me now?
No, I... Seriously, I didn't mean to...
Maybe I shouldn't have said that. Ooh, a panther? Yeah. I think it's just a normal... No, it's not a tabby cat. Maybe it's a panther? Maybe he is a panther? Yeah, I think you might be right. But how are you anyway? Hope you keep him well.
As for me, it was the first time in days that I had gone to bed without my daily baby. A real shame.
All these flashbacks. I wonder if they're actually going to show what happened to the girlfriend.
Nothing like a bruised body.
Hopefully they do
help
well.
You to sleep like a baby.
Hopefully they do. I'm glad that he went to sleep. Child prostitution? Like, no.
Maybe I should have given myself a beef.
Oh, so Cyber, you doing good? Awesome. Awesome. I've been meaning to catch your streams, but I think it's time zones. Makes it quite difficult for me. But I do try to catch him like afterwards. And plus I always host your streams. Like I auto host the streams on my channel, so we gotta get more people to get you to partner, you know what I mean? And if I can help, then yeah, it makes me happy.
Blacksad.
Blacksad. I need you at the gym now, please. Let's bring it on. All right, I'm back in the office. No, I'm not. I'm back at the gym.
When
okay.
I got here.
Gym break-in. When did you? Did they touch anything? Did you call the police? When?
When did you get here?
I've been calling you for over an hour.
Calm down.
I had a rough night. okay. Let's
start.
Have
you already finished looking through these papers?
I wish.
Well, I guess you'll enjoy sorting all this again.
Alright, okay. I need to find out if they took anything in particular. Wait. Alright, okay, what's this?
Bingo.
What is it?
Nothing. Just a freshly signed contract.
What's our time zone difference? Well, right now in the UK, it's 10 to 9 at night. The clues collected allow new deductions. I got 4 deductions to do? Hmm. Let's get it. Right, let's see if I can try and piece these things together. He always plays it safe. Be this? Yeah? Okay, that's one.
It looks like O'Leary has rigged the fight between Stone and Yale.
Right, he rigged the fight between them both. Okay. I think there's 3 more deductions that I can do. So O'Leary has rigged the fight between Yale and Stone. The clues collect. Yeah, the new deductions. Okay, so there's 2 more that I can do? Okay. So what were the new ones that came up there? Maybe Avenarius? No. O'Leary has a guilty conscience ratting somebody out when he was 14. Somebody ended up dead. That needs to be one, but what could I link that with? O'Leary keeps romantic pictures of Helen Moore in a drawer. Maybe. Right, okay. That's
it's
cool.
It's pretty clear that Helen Moore's cigarette case was a gift from O'Leary.
Hmm. They are both still in love. The new deductions. Okay. Let's keep solving them. Because the more that I solve, the more they'll keep throwing me like further into the case. Right. Alright, let's see what's next. What was new that just came up? Moore says that she hates a... Okay. Right, okay. So it might be these two. Yeah, thought so.
If she's still in love, why does she claim she hates him?
And what's she hiding?
What is she hiding?
Yeah. I think that's all the deductions I've done there. But I just need to keep scoping the place.
Do you like sardines?
Excuse me?
Do you like sardines?
Ugh.
So the robber smells sardines, so... paper tissue that smells like sardines in the gym office. I would wear gloves for that. I'm just saying. But I guess not.
Looks like the burglar isn't interested in bureaucracy.
And didn't take the money either.
Not that I suspected otherwise. But it's obvious they weren't looking for money.
Did they take anything?
No. Although...
Did you get back your gun in the hospital?
When you went in the hospital room to get your purse, did you get the gun as well?
Yes. Isn't it there? I put it back. I'd rather not go through that again.
Right, okay. Believe Sonia, accuse Sonia of lying, doubt Sonia, I'll believe her.
That's too bad. It looks like they took it.
I need to find a missing gun, which is probably going to be used to kill Yale, that is in the hospital now. Which is from the doctor, who I didn't know who he was. And yeah. It might be that. Right, okay. Can I not leave? Okay, I can leave. Oh, she's gonna let me leave. Alright, cool. Thanks, Sonia. What's this?
Who's this that?
Mary Purnell.
You think she did this?
Wait. Would Mary have been in here? Or did Mary come back to find out something to help Yale? Let's check the ceiling. Let's check the air, the rooftop. Why can't I move up? Can I not go up on the... Alright, fine, whatever. What did it ask me to see? Oh. Right. So she was here, but... I need to find out who that was. Is there a clue here that I can see? No? Alright, deduction time. Let's see if that plays a part in it. So, what was the one that was just popped up? So, feeds the feet on the table, the sign of dominance. Security conscience for ratting someone out when he was 14, somebody ends up dead. Doesn't matter how to plan the cat out. Yale is one of O'Leary's untouchables according to his file. Yale's soles don't match the footprints at the gym. Who's the guy passing? I need to find out who he is. I know I'll find out later, but I'm just like, I want to find out now. Well, maybe I can go upstairs. Maybe they'll allow me to do that. I mean, hopefully. Aha, I can do.
Wait here, please.
Right. Oh, Mary. Oh, no way. I didn't think that she was gonna die. But then she was in a sticky situation.
Could be a knife wound. The murder was brutal.
So who would have possessed a knife? Right, okay. Why didn't the murderer take that, though?
Dear Sonia, I need to tell you several things
about your father. In fact, I know he would have wanted me to tell you. Among them, the fact that you co-own an apartment in Manhattan. Please call me. Yours truly, Mary Purnell.
Oh, right. I'm gonna have to go back to Sonia and be like, yo, you gotta clean up upstairs, man.
If I were you, I wouldn't quit. Trust me, it might be painful at first, but time heals all wounds. Why did you listen to me?
Tears,
and then go straight to a friend's house. Don't even think about going home, and definitely don't come back here.
I'm staying at a friend's house. I haven't even set foot in my father's place yet.
Good. Do you have the keys? If the murderer didn't find what he was looking for, that might be his next stop. If he hasn't been there yet.
Yep. That's what I'm thinking. But then passing her the note, would that even matter now?
For once I had the keys to the place, which meant I wouldn't have to use my lockpicks or...
But it's locked. Man, this dude's weak. That chain does not look strong at all. Boop. Yeah, no worries, Cyber. We'll see you very soon. Thanks for popping into the game and saying hi, by the way. And who knows, I might be able to see you soon. But I'm glad that you're liking the game. And yeah, you should definitely pick it up. It's got that prostitution in it. It's got a lot of racism in this game as well. It's got a lot of themes that are definitely not child friendly. So yeah, look into it. We'll see you soon. Oh, there's a lot of stuff.
Look at that. The guy sure had good taste.
Okay. An art, no doubt. People say anything, I say change art for senseless. No, boxing is an art.
I see more art in a boxer's hypnotizing footwork than in certain modern paintings.
I can agree with that. Wait, was that a good idea? If I'm trying to search the place and I'm putting on the music? Yo, I like jazz anyway, so I don't mind. Whoa. Turn around.
It looks like Dunn had already begun to move his things.
Okay.
Dunn? Thorpe? No idea. And these two.
That's the doctor.
They look familiar.
Well, maybe it's not. I'm just speculating because I really want to find out who this doctor is. Is there anything else I need to check? Nope.
It's hard to believe that a pair of boxing fists could play something like this. Although I'm sure he had the lungs for it.
Yeah, you can bet. Did I miss anything down here? I feel like I may have, but I don't think I did. Lucilin, what's up? How you doing? Oh yeah, Wagwan. Sai, stop being such a... Trust. It's all good. It's all good. If y'all want to be like that, then yo, you do it. It's all good. I hope that you keep him well, Luce. Whoa. Okay, right, that one.
I seem to recall Dunn being mad about the pictures, but who knows?
Okay. Right, so have I searched everywhere in here? I don't think I've looked at the book on the coffee table. Or have I? Bartholomew Finn. Father of baseball. So the biography, Dunn's apartment, that is going to add into a new clue. Oh man, I'm going to have to piece a lot of stuff together. Alright, let's see what he has in the fridge.
Ready-made meals on airplane trays in front of the TV. Who would have thought we'd end up eating like this? Dunn died 4 days ago, and that lettuce still looks okay.
Yeah, so somebody's been living in here, obviously, after Dunn died. Sometimes the movements are a bit off on this.
Sardines. It's been open for a few hours.
Yeah, because the killer had some sardines while he was killing Mary. New deductions, yeah. So now I got two. Property sale agreement.
Now I see how Dunn bought the apartment he was going to share with Mary. This place has to be empty in 2 weeks for the new owners. I wonder if Sonia knows about this.
Dunn was going to move in with Mary Pennell. Mary. You're making things very scary. Right, wait, there's a card there. Can I get the card? There you go. Right. Wait.
Boop. Elaine. I think that was Dunn's wife's name, according to Jake.
Okay. At Dunn's place, there is a picture of a tree painted by his wife. I'm gonna have to find that. Right, let's try and do this deduction. If people in the chat want to look into it and help out, then by all means, you're more than welcome to. Paper tissue that smells like sardines in the gym office. Is there anything else that... Yeah. Obviously. An empty can of sardines in Dunn's place opened recently. Yep.
It's pretty clear that the burglar came by the house before heading to the gym, which means he probably didn't find what he was looking for in here.
Yeah. Apart from eating the food, the smelly gym burglar didn't find what he was looking for at Dunn's place. Is that a new deduction? I'll just keep searching.
You still look at her every morning, so many years later, with a new love? Maybe we don't need to forget. Maybe pain just transforms into, I don't know, something.
So this dude was just a player then, wasn't he? For the world's best dad on Father's Day, Sonia. I should take that. Sure, to Sonia be like, see, he was a good dad. Okay, he's dead, but he was a good dad. Let's have a look through the diary. My dear Mary, I bring you to this rooftop, the place where... Oh, she's dead! I shouldn't joke. Where the love I feel for you was born, to give you this ring and... Oh my gosh!
This is too private.
But he wants to keep reading. Sorry, y'all. It's not at y'all. It's not at the game. It's literally just me. I forgot to take my pills. yo, let's check. Is the killer going to be in here? I hope not. I've seen way too many movies where he would be hiding in there. Turn around, man. Okay. Wait, I checked the painting again? Did I miss something? No, I didn't. Okay. Bathroom time.
Wow. Could Dunn really afford such luxuries? Or did he only want to impress
Black
Mary?
Panther. All the way from Wakanda. Masculinity starts at work. What if you work at home, though? Hey, yo, Peps. What's up, girl? Wagwan. How you doing? Hope that you keep well. Oh, there's a card. I really want to go out from... Right. Hold on.
Is this how he got in?
Hmm. Question is, who is it? I'd love to know who it was.
Could this be the origin of Sonia's interest in business management?
I haven't played with one of those in ages. Why do I have a feeling that the killer is still circulating here? I mean, I'm putting on the LP. I'm putting on this. It's just like, hello, somebody's in here. Under
your one of the very few teen idols who only got better with age.
All right, what have we got here? Cool.
What's this doing here?
Spano's glove in Sonia Dunn's room?
No matter how hard I look, I'm not getting anywhere. I need to talk with Sonia. Yeah. And maybe with her uncle, Tim.
Yep. Alright, gonna have some words, and then get some deductions done, and then... Yeah.
It brings back... I don't know.
Good memories?
Good memories?
An optimist, are we? It's like remembering the last day of summer. Yeah. Scenes full of joy, picturesque landscapes, and yet the light is faint and the air is still. The calm before the storm.
I know the feeling.
I know that feeling.
I figured that much.
Let's just hope he doesn't ask me like,
your eyes.
Oh, so
we met in
how
the
do
army. We were all professional athletes. They called us the Olympic Five.
Right. Yo, who is this guy?
Who's the guy on the left?
Victor Sukovsky, the athlete. You've probably heard of his medals.
That wasn't the doctor, was it?
Hey, isn't that Craig Spano? The guy on the Morley's billboards?
Yes, indeed. Our captain. He was the oldest, after all.
Would he have been there?
And star of the New York Warriors. He was
done
an orphan,
superior,
you know,
during the war.
But he loved the sport so much that he said baseball was his family.
Right. Spano is an orphan.
Who's the guy on the right?
Angus Mitchell, our combat medic, and a doctor with the New York Warriors, which is how he met Spano. It was Spano who got him assigned to our platoon.
Right, okay.
Was Dunn already boxing?
Yes, he was. I had already seen him fight before I even met him. He was as humble in the ring as he was in life. He'd always let his rivals take the initiative. I remember how he barely dodged the blows. If you didn't look at his feet, it seemed like he wasn't even moving. And the footwork, pure dancing. You could almost hear the music. The song would play until his opponent was exhausted. Then came the drum roll, followed by Dunn's victory by KO.
I like that analogy. That's nice.
What about you?
I had just signed with the Milestones. I hadn't even played my first game, but people said I had a bright future ahead of me.
But the war got in your way. But the war, yeah.
But the war got in the way of that bright future.
Huh? No, I made it big when I came back. Best time of my life. Don't you remember that cop at the hospital? The one who let me in exchange for an autograph?
Oh, yeah, trust dude.
Nobody calls you Iron Arm if you're just sitting on the bench.
Yeah,
who would
I picked
have
the wrong
thought that I'd
one
end up becoming Tim Iron Legs Thorpe?
What happened?
I fought the Nazis for 2 years, up there in the sky, over Europe. And I never set foot in a field hospital. 3 years later, I crossed the street without looking. And look at me now.
Ah, okay. Thorpe's accident. Okay.
What happened to all of them?
Zukovsky died the same day the injured Dunn. Dunn received an honorable discharge and came home.
Right.
He quit boxing and opened his gym. Mitchell was redeployed to a field hospital. Spano and I continued in the same unit, but nothing was ever the same. You see what I meant with the last day of summer?
Why is this blurred?
And after the war?
It's not my eyesight, is it?
Well, who the hell cares?
But it can't be.
I do.
What happened to Spano? What happened to Spano? Yeah, because of his glove and because he's an orphan. Yeah.
What happened to Spano?
Well, you've seen the billboards. He made it big time. When I was forced to retire, I got him some advertising deals. That's how I founded this agency. But then, something happened.
Yo, Shiro, what's up, man?
He became solid.
Yeah, I'm playing the Lion King, detective style.
Slowly but surely, lost touch with reality. He withdrew from public life and broke off our friendship. Haven't heard from him in, what, 3 years?
Maybe Spano's a part of this. He's been missing for 3 years. Maybe he was hired to... You think Spano was involved in Dunn's death? I can't just throw that in straight away. Must just ask what happened to Mitchell.
What happened to Mitchell after the war?
Mitchell? Who knows? We lost touch. I hope he's doing well.
I think I saw Mitchell not too long ago. Did I?
You think Spano
might
have
been involved with a hunch in Dunn's maybe. Death?
Spano? No way. He and Dunn were always... Well, Spano's changed so much that it's hard to say.
I don't know why this is blurry, though.
I think I saw Mitchell not too long ago, but I can't remember where.
Seriously? Please, try to remember. I'd love to hear from him again.
I'll do my best.
Allow me to double your wage. You have to find the murderer. Maybe Dunn stayed in touch with Mitchell or Spano. Maybe even with both.
Yeah,
but
I'm gonna have to try
and
get in contact with them.
Maybe Sonia knows.
I doubt it. But that's not the only question I've got for her. May I?
After this, should I look into the deductions?
Sonia?
No, she's not here. Who's calling?
Where is she?
Right, okay. You do not want to be sitting there. Everybody's dying left, right, and center. You do not want to be sitting there. Okay, you can sit there as well. Alright. Was your father in touch with Spano or Mitchell? Don't do it. It's dangerous here. I'll try and be cool with her for a bit.
Have you ever wished you'd never been born?
What?
Now and then.
Yeah, sometimes.
Then we're both in the same boat. First time was right after moving to New York. I hated my mother. She was the reason we moved from the countryside and the smell of freshly mowed grass to this dirty city and the smell of medicine. Her medicine. The
so
second
mother was
time
a doctor,
was
father
after
was a boxer.
She died.
Good connection.
I hated myself for having hated her before. For not having loved her enough. The third time was when my father shut himself
Black Sad's just looking like,
I
get
hated
to the
him
point.
For abandoning me. For giving in to the booze. Now he's dead, so take a guess.
You hate yourself for hating, you realize how much you loved him.
You've realized just how much you really loved him.
I guess so. But that's not the worst of it. The problem is I don't know how to live without hating him.
I'm just trying
over
to choose the choices
years,
that will make
everything
her feel
I've
better,
done
not
was
both,
meant
you
to
know.
Push my father far away.
Yeah.
To avoid being like him. To avoid making his same mistakes. Without him, I just don't know who I am. And you won't even let me hate Bobby. Which might actually help me.
The more you hate, the worse you feel. Bobby Yale doesn't deserve your hate. The people you hate wind up dead.
The more you hate, the worse you feel.
You think I don't know that? I need someone to blame.
Your advice didn't help, Sonia.
Without
oh,
that
man.
Someone.
One step
I
forward.
I have only myself to hate.
Two steps back. I'll find the person who did this.
I'll find the person who did this. I promise.
Oh, I just had to throw a promise
Let
in there.
Let me have my doubts. Although, you've already come so far. I'm sorry I haven't been a little more grateful.
In any case, you shouldn't hate yourself. You are... No, you have such good qualities.
Beautiful, smart, smart, and kind. Kind, smart, and beautiful. Just throw all of them in.
And beautiful.
Are you really trying to flatter me now?
No, I... Seriously, I didn't mean to...
Maybe I shouldn't have said that.
Sorry.
Anyway, can we just drop the subject?
Your compliments bothered.
Did you go to my father's apartment?
Yes. The thief went there before coming to the gym.
2 out of 3.
Which leads me to believe he didn't find what he was looking for.
And what was he looking for?
That's what I intend to find out. With your help.
Right, let's just slow down. There's no timer on this. And just try and pick a decent one. He had great taste in music, childhood room. Dunn sold his apartment, wall picture.
I saw your old room.
That's embarrassing. Stop, or I'll end up hating you.
Anyway, I found a baseball glove in your room. There's a small box that you can keep. I like, and probably the abacus.
It's odd that there are practically no toys or memories of your childhood in the room, except for a small music box.
That box? It might just be my last happy memory.
That was a bonus.
It's from before my mother got sick and we moved here. I loved reading stories about pirates.
It looks like that take right out of the comic.
My father drew a treasure map for me. I searched the whole house, one clue at a time. It led me to this enormous tree in the yard where Daddy had put up a tire swing.
The image.
X marks the spot, so I dug to find my treasure. I loved the music it played. The ballerina and the little secret compartment. Oh, the secrets I kept in there.
I think it's the first time I heard you call your father Daddy.
Really?
See? The hate is going away. Dunn hit the music box under the swing tire tree. I found a baseball glove in your room. I have a feeling I'm going to choose something, right? It's really going to knock her off. Whatever.
I found a baseball glove with Spano's autograph in your room.
Oh, I've never seen it. My father must have put it there. Although I don't remember him having a signed glove.
I like Frank Papalia.
I'm also a fan of Frank Papalia.
Oh, yeah. The poster. I only liked him because my father thought he was too modern.
Dunsell's apartment, he had great taste in music, war picture. He had great taste in music.
Your dad had great taste in music.
So, better taste than I had as a child?
Well, now you've put me on the spot.
You don't know how happy that makes me.
War picture.
I found a picture taken during the war.
The Olympic Five.
Did you meet any of them, besides your father and uncle?
Well, Uncle Tim actually isn't my uncle.
What?
No.
He and my father loved each other like brothers. Did he tell you that he saved his life?
Thorpe saved your father. Your father saved Thorpe.
Your father saved Thorpe?
They were flying over Brittany in a 3-unit fighter plane.
I hope that was the right one.
Zukovsky was the pilot, my father was the co-pilot, and my uncle manned the machine gun. Suddenly, enemy fire killed Zukovsky and injured my father, which is why he never boxed again. My uncle jumped out of the gun turret, ran to the cockpit, and managed to pilot the plane to safety. Oh, the times my father told me that story. And now...
Thorpe saved Dunn. Now, you still have your uncle. What can you tell me about Spano? Can you tell me about Mitchell? I still need to play it cool with her, otherwise if I ask her a question like, can you tell me about Spano now, she'd be like, seriously, I'm in a vulnerable place and you're just firing these questions at me, it doesn't really go down with people. Yeah.
You still have your uncle.
Yes, I guess you're right.
He's not really her uncle, I know.
Maybe he can also save me.
You managed to make Sonia look on the bright side. I'm glad that I made her feel reassured.
Did you ever meet Spano? What can you tell me about him?
I think I saw him once, but I was just a little girl. I think my uncle turned him into a star. That was a long time ago.
And Mitchell?
Did you ever meet Mitchell, the doctor?
Mitchell? The lizard? No, never. Why?
Oh, nothing. I think I've seen him somewhere.
It's the doctor. Are you cold?
Are you cold?
A little. Maybe I should go.
Take off your coat and put it on her. Yeah, it's getting late. I still have a couple of questions. Need more info.
Wait, I still have a couple of questions for you.
Dunn sold his apartment.
Your father sold his apartment. The new owners move in 2 weeks.
What?
I'm sorry. I think he used the money to buy a new place with Mary Purnell. The letter you're holding explains the rest.
Mm-hmm.
I wish I'd had the chance to talk to her.
The letter.
Well, I think you've already answered all my questions.
It's about time. I thought you were waiting for me to freeze out here.
Well, I could have more questions. I just put the coat on you and then that's it.
Anyway. Thanks for the company.
You're welcome. Now, when do I get paid? That was some cake. I should have said thank you.
I knew I was looking at a solution, but what exactly needed solving?
I didn't expect cake there. Right, okay. So let's, got three. Wait, at Dunn's place there's a picture of a tree painted by his wife. Dunn hid the music box under the swing tire tree. Yeah. Okay.
Hmm. Maybe Dunn used the same hiding place once more.
Possibly. Yo, my man, who are you?
I'll never understand why detectives and criminals bluster while they fight each other in the pictures.
Right.
What a waste
which one do I need
breath,
to hit?
Focus, and energy.
Come on. What? I should have been alright there. Dude. Oh man, that was close. I thought he was actually like gonna take me out there. Odd fuck. Pull yourself up. Just let her get hit, dude. Get on it. Whoa. I moved. What? I pressed left. That was weird. Alright, let's try that again.
See, I'll never understand why detectives and criminals bluster while they fight each other.
There's X, isn't it?
What a waste
gonna change
of breath,
that.
Focus, and energy.
It only makes you go near halfway anyway. And now it's B. Cool. Right, now I'm gonna hit left, alright? Then hopefully... Hopefully I can just take him out.
It's not the lack of credibility in the screenplay that bothers me.
I gotta make sure that I hit all of these,
Plus, it's actually pretty handy.
Alright, cool, I got that.
When a crook talks to you in the middle of a fight, you know you're up against a rookie.
Vertigo!
And if he doesn't even say, help me, please.
I need the questions anyway. Or not. Well, it softened his blow, so... Meh, he'll be alright. Ain't too bad. But yeah, you're on it, aren't you? Yeah.
What did they say? Your
time to shoot him, just in case? No, should have went bang, bang, right?
I lost another one of my
shoot first, ask questions later.
Oh, this hurts.
Got many left?
I'm in the red. He hasn't woken up yet?
Nope. We're gonna be here a while. Vulpine, 7 letters.
I didn't hear what you said. Scheming?
Scheming?
You think that's the same thing? No, no, no. Sounds a bit off to me.
I didn't hear what you said. The anteater's snout reeks of sardines, because he is the killer. But who hired him, though? That's what I want to know. Anteater wears relatively small shoes. Was he at the gym as well? As in, near the paint? The anteater has a pair that tear in his pants.
Wait, I know. Vulpine, 7 letters. Cunning. What are you looking for?
Nothing. Will he live?
He'll live.
So what have you found out?
Randall Lee. Apparently in love with our penitentiary system, judging by the frequency of his visits. Theft, assault, extortion, you know, minor things of the sort.
Any partners? Okay.
Always works alone. He's never ratted out his employers, provided they exist. Did you find anything? Is this our man?
So wait, he was working... proof? Nah, he wasn't working solo. Somebody took him out. He had a tear in his pants. Anteater snout reeks of sardines. Hold on. That one? And obviously, he has a tear in his pants. Yeah.
It looks like we know who tore his pants following Mary Purnell up to the rooftop.
Right. Yeah. But who hired
his pants have a tear in them. I found a piece of that same fabric at the gym, on the stairs that lead to the rooftop where we found the second body.
Makes sense, but how many pairs of ripped pants are walking around New York City?
Oh man, this dude is such a cynic.
And
it's like
that evidence.
I'm giving him hard evidence, man. And right, okay, let's do it again. Right. Right, the sardines bit. Let's see what else comes up with sardines. The anteater's snout reeks of sardines, and the smelly gym burglar didn't find what he was looking for at Dunn's place.
The guy who broke into the gym in Dunn's place has a thing for sardines. Did you smell his breath?
Right, because there's only one sardine fanatic on this side of the Hudson. I need something more.
Oh my days. This dude is just... he's ruthless. The burglar signed a document with his foot, and he has small feet. Where's that one? And who do the footprints at the gym belong to? There you go. Let's see if
he
believes
this. I saw
footprints
from those very same shoes next to both the gym murders.
Unless you're telling me that shoe is a limited edition, I'm gonna need something else.
This guy, I'm just gonna tell him the world and he'll be like, man, whatever. What about two thugs trying to scare me into leaving the case, but one of them was trigger happy. And the anteater broke. Nah, it won't be these two. No, it is. Okay.
One of the thugs that attacked me the other night had a snout just like his.
I'm sorry, but you can't incriminate someone based solely on species. What else you got?
What more do you need? I've given you 4 pieces of evidence.
Yeah, exactly.
None of which are conclusive.
He tried to throw me off the rooftop.
Yeah, you're right. I'm sorry. He's our man.
No, he's not our man.
Make up your mind.
He's just a puppet. Someone is pulling his strings.
Could it be Yale?
He's innocent, but he's hiding something.
He's hiding something for sure. But I don't think he did it. By the way, was he discharged? His room is empty.
They let him out yesterday. He's in police custody now.
Okay, can I go to the station?
You can tell he's an athlete. Made quite the comeback. Anyone else would have taken 10 times as long. Anyway, he better be fine. You know they've ordered me to escort him to Madison Square Garden on the day of the fight.
So I heard.
Yeah, I heard something of the sort.
What have you heard?
I never rely on my sources. Frank Cassidy.
Frank Cassidy. He's friends with the governor.
You don't say. I guess I shouldn't be surprised.
I can't get anything past this guy. I told Smirnoff what you know about Cassidy. I just need to get his support.
Quick, what do you want? Good cop or bad cop?
I'll have good cop.
I'm the good guy.
He quickly just asked me out on that. Yeah, all right.
Good thing someone took out the trash.
Right, let's see how this goes down.
You're saved by garbage, you piece of trash. But you're gonna wish it hadn't.
Go to hell, you dog.
He's right.
My partner is right. We'll ruin your life.
Yep. Unless you collaborate, that is. We know you killed Joe Dunn and Mary Purnell, you bastard.
I'll call your bluff. You ain't got nothing.
Are you acquainted with our usual witness program? For a modest sum, they'll say they saw your sorry snout when and where we tell them to.
We're no strangers to false evidence.
Basically playing bad cop here.
We could arrest your sorry ass for more crimes than you've committed.
Although it is odd that my partner won't offer you a deal in exchange for telling us who hired you.
What can you offer me?
Yeah, I should have chose the other one.
We could significantly reduce your sentence. I could testify that you helped me on the rooftop. You're pathetic.
What? I didn't stick to the good cop rule? Oh, so that one choice, right?
Did you fail the good cop, bad cop test? I won't say a word. And believe me,
yeah, I messed
you
up.
Stand to lose. Care for a piece of advice? If I were you, I'd fear for my life.
I guess I'm just so used to being a bad cop all the time.
Whoa. Watch out!
I did not expect that. What? There you are. Did I ask? You actually got him. Those cat senses. But yeah, that good cop, bad cop thing, I really messed up. I don't think I was going to get any answers from him anyway. Because this is linear, so. Yeah.
Luckily, Smirnov's wound wasn't as bad as Randall's.
Yeah, Smirnov, you're going to believe me now?
Unfortunately, the police found nothing on the nearby rooftops. Our best shot at finding the killer was gone. So I went back to my previous lead.
It did light up, right? I didn't really see it, you know. Yeah. Wow. We actually could have pulled some evidence out from him, but... Nah, we weren't going to anyway. Because that's the thing. Don't stand near a window in times like that.